future.
If things get physical, we have to separate.
No. Yeah.
There can be no physical violence.
I can't promise you that I'll be perfect. I can't promise you I won't get physical again. God, I fucking sometimes get so mad, I lose it.
Get in a fight or something?
Oh, thank you. Got into an altercation.
Ow.
I already talked about it. I won't talk about it anymore.
I can't believe Amber beat your ass. I know you could beat her ass.
We're not going to talk about that.
Whitney, truth or dare? Okay, did you really start the fight with your sister or did she start it? For real, for real, for real.
We're not going to talk about that.
She really did whoop your butt.
Oh, we're not talking about it.
Yeah, I'm done. I guess I'm done talking about it.
Well, you previously testified that you were the CEO for Art of Elysium. Is that correct?
That is correct.
And are you still currently in that position?
Yes, I am.
And how long have you been the CEO for Art of Elysium?
I am the founder of the organization, so.
Ms. Howell, when did you first meet Amber Heard?
I was a guest of James Franco, and Amber was in the movie. The Pineapple Express premiere is where I met she and her sister Whitney. And so I met she and her sister at the, I mean, to be specific, at the after party of the premiere.
I liked Whitney very much. Initially, I mean, when I first met her, I liked her very much. And grew to love Whitney. Very much. Because I always, it seemed, Whitney, Amber's sister, Whitney seemed to always get the sort of dirty end of the stick. And I felt bad for her for that because it wasn't new. It had been there for life. That was seemed pretty obvious. So I took to Whitney very, very quickly, very easily. She was a very sweet kid. She was wonderful.
What do you mean that Whitney got the dirty end of the stick?
It was a kind of a strange combination of loving sister, trusted sister and friend, and then lackey. And then, you know, either the punching bag or the dartboard, or the recipient of some rather demeaning and ugly words. Or she would have wine thrown in her face.
And who was the source of those demeaning words and the wine that you just referenced?
Well, that would be Amber Heard, her sister.
And how do you know that?
Well, I witnessed quite a lot of it. The wine in the face was something that happened in New York, which
how did you first learn about that incident?
Miss Heard told me in detail.
What else did you observe of Miss Heard and her sister Whitney's interactions during your relationship with Miss Heard?
They were just constantly up and down, but I could sense, I could feel that Whitney was trying to please her sister, trying to be up to snuff, and it just seemed like she got shot down.
Objection, Your Honor. Scott.
Did Miss Enriquez end up working for Art of Elysium at some point?
Yes, she did.
What year did Miss Enriquez begin working with Art of Elysium?
I believe it was in 2014. I don't have those.
And what was Miss Enriquez's position at Art of Elysium?
Art salon manager, director.
The corner of my eye, I saw a fist and an arm come across my right shoulder, and I heard and saw a closed fist contact Mr. Depp in the left side of his face.
And whose fist was that?
That was Miss Heard's fist, Amber Heard's fist.
This took place on the landing, where she was coming out, you know, trying to, trying to get to me, trying to hit me, trying to do anything she could, and then Whitney, her sister, was there, who who stepped in the way, and. Interesting thing was is that Whitney stepped in front of Amber and was facing Amber to stop Amber, and when she was in between us, Amber snuck in the got the roundhouse in and nailed me on the cheekbone.
The Declaration of Jennifer Howell. I, Jennifer Howell, declare as follows. Whitney Enriquez, whose maiden name is Whitney Heard, is my dear friend. She has told me that I am her chosen sister, and I also call her my chosen sister. Whitney worked for me in a nonprofit organization that I founded 22 years ago and run, called the Art of Elysium. We take artists and help them be of service in communities. Whitney told me she tried to stop her sister from attacking Johnny on the stairs. Whitney told me when she tried to intervene to stop Amber from going after Johnny, Amber nearly pushed Whitney down the stairs. She told me she was worried Amber was going to kill Johnny. She told me she had endured that kind of abuse her entire life, first from her father, and then from Amber, who she said was extremely violent.
During a conversation we had in the spring of 2016, I asked Whitney why she had moved in with Jennifer Howell, the founder of the Art of Elysium, and who lived two floors above my office. She relayed to me a story about having to stop her sister Amber from attacking Johnny, and in the process how Amber almost knocked her down a flight of stairs.
Acknowledge.
There's also Travis. There's Travis coming to get me. There's Travis having to come up and pull me away from you.
You ever punch Johnny Depp with a closed fist in the history of your relationship with Johnny?
Answer it however you feel you wish to.
One time, Johnny was hitting me, and he was hitting me hard and repeatedly, and I was screaming. Security walks in, and they don't do anything about it. And there, he makes this motion when Jerry Judge yells, "Fox," or Sean, I can't remember who it was. And all we had was a little bit of separation, and my sister runs down the stairs. We're on a landing in between two flights of stairs.
Miss Heard, I must interrupt you because
you
I've
can't.
Asked you a yes
then
or no
withdraw
question.
Withdraw your question then because
Ms.
she's
Heard,
answering.
Prior to today's date, had any time, has Johnny, have you ever hit Johnny Depp?
Answer it however you wish. You've already asked, and she's already answered, and you interrupted her.
Ms. Heard, have you ever hit Johnny Depp prior to today?
Church in Vegas at times.
Hey, everyone on this side of the room, please.
Objection 352. It's not relevant to this domestic violence proceeding.
Overruled.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Answer it however you want to, including the way you were just...
asking for a yes or no answer.
You don't have to answer it the way she wants you to answer it.
He was about to push my sister down the stairs. She was attempting to break us up. I am protective over my baby sister. When he laid hands on her, I don't know what I did, but I know I jumped in between the actions that I saw could lead to a fatal injury to my sister. She was standing on the top of a flight of the stairs, and she has never hurt anyone in her life, and she does not deserve to be pushed down the flight of stairs. And it looked like she was about to be. And I would have done what anybody who has a child or a sister would have done I acted defensively in her life. I saw her standing on top of a flight of stairs and trying to interrupt a fight in between him and I. I don't know what part of my body I put in between me and him and her. But I would have done anything. I would have done anything to prevent her from being pushed down a flight of stairs.
Any other, I don't hesitate, I don't wait, I just in my head instantly think of Kate Moss and the stairs, and I swung at him. In all of my relationship to date with Johnny, I hadn't landed a blow. And I, for the first time, hit him, like actually hit him, square in the face.
Mr. Depp's finger was freshly injured at this point, right?
He had a cast on it.
The top of his right finger had been cut off 2 weeks prior.
That is correct.
And he had a pin in his finger, true?
I don't recall when the pin was placed.
A skin graft?
I'm not quite sure. He had several different procedures and they were kind of spread out over a period of time, so I don't remember what happened and when
one of those
exactly.
Procedures was to treat the MRSA that got on his finger too, right?
At some point I knew he had an infection.
And his right hand was in a bandage, right?
It was casted.
So it's your testimony that Mr. Depp was able to attack both you and your sister with his hand in that state, right?
That is correct. He had a hard plaster cast on it.
So it's your testimony under oath. You threw nothing at Mr. Depp. Mr. McGivern's line.
I have thrown things at Johnny,
no,
to be clear.
Not
that occasion.
That evening.
Not on that occasion.
So it's your testimony, Mr. McGivern. Imagine that you were throwing things at Mr. Depp from the mezzanine level down towards where Mr. Depp and Mr. McGivern were standing.
Well, he certainly wasn't going to say it about his client.
Oh, rare occasions where I was sober.
You testified that Mr. Depp allegedly hit you during that incident, right?
Yes.
But you weren't sure if that contact was even meant for you, right?
I honestly don't. I don't know what he was aiming for. My back was to him.
And you weren't injured during that incident, right?
No, I wasn't.
And you didn't seek medical attention?
No.
And you said Debbie Lloyd was there during all of that, correct?
She was.
And Mr. Depp's security, Travis McGivern, was there too?
Yes, he was.
And you saw your sister hit Mr. Depp on the stairs that day, right?
After he struck me, yes.
You said she landed one, right? Mm-hmm. And then the next day you found some damage in the adjoining penthouse.
Correct.
And we saw some pictures of what you saw that day, right?
Yes.
You thought it was important to document that damage, right?
Not to document. It was Kevin's job to kind of clean up the houses, take care of the houses. I took pictures just so he could be aware of what he would need to bring. I didn't know if he had tools here or whatever. I was just preparing him for what he was going to have to fix.
But you didn't take any pictures of your sister that day, right?
No, I didn't.
Now, after March 2015, you continued to have a close relationship with Mr. Depp, right?
Yes.
And you still loved him?
Of course.
And you were there for him if he needed you, right?
Of course.
And in fact, just a couple of weeks after that staircase incident, you were still acting as the marriage counselor, weren't you?
At some point, sure. Yeah, vaguely. I mean, they're clearly my text messages, but yeah, I recognize them, I think.
Okay. And if we can go to the third page, please, Tom. And you'll see the second blue box from the bottom there. You texted Mr. Depp and you said, I love both of you so much and would fucking stay out of it if I thought this shit were past the point of no return. Mm-hmm. But that's not where you guys are right now. Did I read that right?
Oh, but that's not where you guys are at.
Yes. Yeah. So you didn't think they were past the point of no return in October 2015, right?
At that point, clearly, I didn't.
you send this email and letter to Ms. Enriquez?
Because I've struggled very much with what to do in a situation that I love someone who I know is doing something very wrong, and I know that they're doing it because they're trying to protect their sister, and I'm trying to protect her, and I'm just trying to get her to wake up and do the right thing, which is tell the truth. It's the only thing that can help everybody involved in this case.
Dear Whitney, the incident on the stairs that was one of the inciting events that led you to ask to move in with me. You told me and others on staff that you tried to stop Amber from attacking Johnny and nearly got thrown down the stairs. At no point in time was it ever said to me that Johnny had hit Amber nor abused her in any way. Had you ever expressed concern that Johnny was abusing Amber, I would have gotten a social worker or someone to help you to remove your sister from that situation. I would have done anything to help you in any way. Dear Whitney, lie 2, you saying she was never abusive to you. You told me, the entire office, personal friends of mine about how abusive she has been to you her entire life. You came to stay with me because of her being abusive. My father reminded me when he and my stepmother were giving me a conversation on morals and telling me that this is my job to tell the truth, that I told him you were staying with me because you were terrified of your sister. My father, parents, and me have absolutely nothing in this case other than being honest, doing the right thing and trying to save you and have you come forward in integrity to do the right thing. You told the entire office that Amber cut off Johnny's finger. You told us the play-by-play. You said multiple times she is going to fucking kill him. You told the entire office about her throwing a wine glass at you in an elevator in New York that was full of wine. When reading through the statements, someone said that they had been warned she was a thrower and get out of the way of her projectiles. This completely confirms your story about her throwing a glass full of wine on you. I am one of about a dozen people who heard these two stories come out of your mouth. Why would you sit on stand and say she has never been abusive? What I am beginning to piece together in all of this is you lying about that. Her lying about drugs and drinking are just the little lies covering up the much bigger lie in all of this.
Up and offer me your certificate.
You want us to pay you?
Do you have a problem with those things on the side of your head? Am I not the captain of this ship?
Where's the treasure? All of us are starving.
Yesterday we eat a rat. Vai avanti.
What did Ms. Heard report to you?
That it was a point of pride, two things. It was a point of pride to her if she felt disrespected to initiate a fight. And the second, one is what she reported to me, which is if he was going to leave her to de-escalate from the fight, she would strike him to keep him there. She would rather be in a fight than have him leave. Abandonment and having him leave was her worst nightmare.
Please come here. I'm not insulting you. I have not been insulting you. I love you. Johnny, what do you need me to do? I love you. Stop.
Don't smack me in the ear again.
I don't
smack my ear again. So it fucking resounds in my fucking cranium. You like that?
I'm not going to be in a physical fucking altercation with you. We're on a plane, I can't split.
No.
On the plane here from Rio,
you don't admit it.
You were losing your marbles. I'm the one who came to you and said, let's calm down, please calm down. And you were blaming me.
What do you understand happened after Ms. Heard auditioned for Aquaman?
after Ms. Heard's audition, or possibly auditions, for Warner Brothers and the creative team, I was informed by Ms. Heard that the film was going to be shooting in Australia, and that was of concern to her, and because it was of concern to Warner Brothers, so she asked if I would, because I'd had a multi for a few years. I'd had a multi-film deal with Warner Brothers, and so we'd been in business together, so I knew these people. I'd been on films with them, so she asked me if I would speak to them. I made a phone call, and I I spoke to the three upper echelon Disney Warner executives, Kevin Sugihara, Sue Kroll, and Greg Silverstein. And I told them that. Well, I can only say that ultimately she did get the job in the film. So hopefully I suppose I had curbed their worries to some degree.
That we all love to hear, certainly. But I think that that's really something that you can visualize, something you can see, something you can feel. But to hear the words, certainly.
Anyway, I opened the bathroom door when you were knocking on it. After a few times I opened, and you just kept going. I tried to close the door three times, you know, please, just don't, you know, and then wait, and then I accidentally, I swear, when I was trying to close the door, I guess it scraped your toes. I didn't mean to do that. And I bent down, and you either pushed or you kicked. I think you kicked the door open. I mean, the door, yeah, more open, so that it would hit me. And it hit
no,
me.
I didn't know
it
that.
It hit me in the fucking head.
But I did not mean to do that. I don't know what.
I was bent down behind the door.
I did not do anything to her. I did not kick a door or push a door so that it would hit you. I did not. I swear that. That was not my intention. I think I remember when the door scraped my toes, I reacted, but this whole the door thing, I never did that. That wasn't on purpose. I might have done it on accident.
Okay.
But
so let's say that was an accident. I then stood up. I don't even know if I said, I might have said, like, what the fuck, you know, whatever, because I'd just been hit in the head with the fucking corner of the door.
I'm so sorry. I did not. I'm sorry.
And then I stood up. And then you fucking clocked me.
I remember hitting you as a response to the door thing. And I'm really sorry about hitting you with the door, hitting your head. I did not mean to, nor...
You didn't mean to hit me in the head with the door, but you meant to punch me in the jaw.
I meant to hit you, and I did not do this thing with the door. I did mean to hit you.
So that you didn't mean?
The door? No, God, no, I didn't.
But punching me in the jaw.
Okay, I'm sorry I hit you. I did mean to hit you, but it was in response. I just reacted in response to My foot, I just reacted. And I'm sorry, it's below me.
Your foot? That was why you punched me?
Yeah.
After you fucking got physically violent with me, I texted Travis. I said, come up here, because I didn't want anything to happen.
I mean, yeah.
Mm-hmm. He's coming to what? Save me?
No, go ahead. Continue. You, Travis to the rescue.
No, that was the last one. You can go, That was the last insult.
Oh, yeah. You called me a liar, and yet.
I watched you lie.
You called me a liar?
I watched you lie. Heard it. I was right there.
There's not what? You still haven't told me what lie it is. Every single fucking time.
We'll talk
to Travis.
You know
you
do
this every single fucking time.
We'll talk to Travis.
I'm not fucking talking to nobody.
No,
fuck that. You go fucking jerk. Go jerk him off. I don't care. I really could care less. It's you every single time. You latch onto some sort of thing. When I already told you, I don't know what you're fucking talking about. You don't even know what you're talking about. You still haven't even told me what it is. But run with it.
I have told you what it is.
No, you haven't.
I said to Travis. I said to you. Hey, tell Travis what just happened.
You told me to do it. Told me to. You said, go do that.
I said, no, tell him what just happened.
And I lied.
And that you punched me in the fucking thing. And
you figured
in
it
the
out.
Face. And you said, no, fucking, no, I didn't. What the fuck are you talking about? And I watched you lie. And then I
didn't punch you, and then by the way. I'm sorry that I didn't
hit
you across the face in a proper slap. But I was hitting you. It was not punching you. Babe, you're not punched.
Don't tell me what it feels like to be punched.
You know, even a lot of fights have been around a long time. I know. Yeah,
no, right? When you fucking have a closed fist.
You didn't get punched. You got hit. I'm sorry I hit you like this. But I did not punch you. I did not fucking deck you. I fucking was hitting you.
You can't.
I don't know
deck
what
me.
The motion of my actual hand was. But you're fine. I did not hurt you. I did not punch you. I was hitting you.
How are your toes?
What am I supposed to do? Do this?
How are your
toes? I'm not sitting here bitching about it, am I? You are.
Oh,
that's the difference between me and you. You're a fucking baby.
Because you start physical fights?
You're such a baby! Because you, the fuck off,
because you start physical fights?
I did start a physical fight.
Yeah, you did.
I think in that recording I made it very clear that I was sorry that the door hit him while he was trying to get into the room I was escaping, or attempting to escape into.
Punch me in the jaw.
I meant to hit you, and I
I did not do this thing with the door. I do remember, I did mean to hit you.
So that you didn't mean?
The door? No, God, no, I didn't.
Put punching on the edge of the jaw.
I'm sorry.
And Johnny, whenever he was injured or touched at all, always referred to it in these ways of punching or clocked or whatever. And whether you discussed it with him or not, the last thing you do in talking to him afterwards or trying to reconcile with him is to get into what the definition of those words mean to him.
He was trying to get through the door. I was trying to barricade.
And Mr. Depp was hiding from you in the bathroom. Isn't that right, Ms. Heard?
Incorrect.
Well, Mr. Depp said on that recording, I opened the bathroom door when you were knocking on it. Doesn't he?
I don't know if he said that, and I didn't hear that.
And Mr. Depp said, when I was trying to close the door, I guess it scraped your toes. He says that, doesn't he?
Correct.
And then you kicked the bathroom door into his head, didn't you?
No, I didn't. And
then you punched him in the
jaw. Defended myself in that audio. You can hear it for yourself.
Right. And then you punched him in the jaw.
I also did not do that. I tried to make that clear on the audio tape, too. So, in futility.
Ms. Heard ran out of the master bedroom, or bedroom, and started just throwing wild punches at me, at the back of my head, at the side of my head, at my anything that she could connect with, and I had to. I would have to show you sort of the how I tried to avoid the attack. If it's all right, John.
Yes, yes, sir.
If I'm walking this way to the door of my office, in the bedroom door is where you are. I'd walked across the mezzanine there, and as I'm approaching the door, suddenly I'm just getting clobbered from behind, and one's natural primal instinct is to kind of duck and cover. So I ducked and covered, but they didn't stop. So I came up this like this, sort of protecting my face, but at the same time, with their arms swinging wildly, I put my arms up and I was able to get her into a bear hug or something, just to stop her from hitting me anymore. And while holding her in that position, she was still trying to, you know, she had her legs, she had her, she could kick, she could, you know, she could knee me. So she was still kind of very angry, very animated. Because of the grabbing of the arms and holding them to her side so that I didn't receive any more blows, and she was still fighting, I believe there was some kind of contact with our heads, our foreheads, as would happen if you're trying to calm someone like that. And then that was when she accused me of headbutting her, of giving her a headbutt and breaking her nose. But there was no blood. There was no, I didn't hit her nose. If there was anything at all, it was a bump of Well, I'm trying to restrain her. She's trying to get out of it. There's going to be some contact here and there, accidental contact, but not a headbutt.
I crammed about 3 months of solid training in, and I'm kind of like working my way up from the floor and learning the technical aspect of ballet. And I've got these dances down technically perfectly. I'm learning all the movements, but the last thing we get to are the hands. And I haven't yet got to that point, but everything else is working, and I'm acting it up on my face, and I'm selling the ballet.
Testified that during the incident on December 15, 2015, Mr. Depp broke the bed, correct?
That is correct.
And more specifically, you described that he broke the bed frame with his boot while trying to get purchase. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct.
Okay. Let's take a look at Defendant's Exhibit 509, which is already in evidence. If we could please have that published to the jury. Thank you. Sir, this is a picture that you indicated depicts the broken bed, right?
That's exactly it.
And it's your testimony that Mr. Depp caused this damage to the bed with his boot, right?
He did.
Is that a pocket knife on the bed there?
I cannot tell what's on the bed.
Did you use that to damage the bed?
I did not damage the bed. Johnny's boot did when he was punching me. I could feel him slipping.
Mr., do you also testify that there was blood all over the pillows on the bed, correct?
On the pillow top, yes. That's correct.
But you didn't take a picture of that, though, did you?
I did not take a picture of this.
I'll tell you one thing that I learned that was one of the best lessons I believe I've ever learned in my life, ever could learn in my life. was based on my experiences as a child and what I'd seen and experienced. I knew exactly how to raise children. I knew exactly how to raise children, which was to do the opposite of what they did, of what Betty Sue did. Never raise your voice in front of the children, never. Nor did Vanessa. We never raised our voices in front of our children, ever.
And there are no attempts to control that emotion. There are no attempts to regulate it. So if they're in the middle of the restaurant and they feel offended, they're gonna start the fight. People are going to see it, or they might just start crying or break down, but they'll make a lot of accusations, and that reactivity is when you're gonna see a lot of this escalation, the bizarre behavior. They can react violently, they can react aggressively, they will.
What things have you been doing?
Working on these things, not doing this sort of thing, trying to change certain things.
Mm-hmm.
Less several times.
Hence, screaming when I spilt wine accidentally on you for falling asleep and screaming in front of my kids and freaking Jack out. And that's trying. That fucked him up, you know.
I'm sorry I fucked your son up.
No, it weirded him out. It never...
I'm so sorry I fucked your kids up.
You didn't fuck my kids up, but... It was pretty fucking weird for him, you know.
Because I jumped up and screamed and I went, that's amazing.
Yeah.
You're right, I'm surprised he's... So
I'm
going for the counts now. I'm sure that's
terrifying. I don't need your clever comebacks. No. You think you're controlling yourself? You think you're controlling yourself?
Your character has become so clear, especially when you use them. It's embarrassing for you. I'm going to walk away now because you're actually making me see you even worse. And
incident between Johnny and Amber here during that trip. Amber was telling him that he was a washed up actor. He was going to die a fat, lonely old man. Then you heard, you hit me with a can. You heard Johnny say, you hit me with a can. And then he came down the steps and Amber was behind him and she had a bottle in her hand, was removed, and there was a brief pause at the moment, I think of initial shock or uncertainty of why, you know, that we were there. Neither Johnny nor Amber knew that we were there. He proceeded to walk back to the John Deere, and she again walked, he was just sitting in the seat. Amber came up to him and was asking him to come back in the house, that she was sorry, please come back in the house. He didn't come out of the seat, and she was hugging and kissing him, and I love you, I love you. She was telling him I loved you. He didn't react. Johnny sat there, eventually got out of the John Deere, and proceeded to start to walk away. At that time, Amber started to grab at him and his shirt and trying to pull him back to the house. Just basically viciously trying to pull him back and get him back into the house and yelling at him. And at that point, I was between them and felt it was best, and I was getting worried about what was going to happen, and it was best that I remove him from the situation. And so CJ took Amber back to the house, and I walked Johnny over to the cafe, which was basically 30 seconds away from the house, because it was the only place I could take him to at the time.
What did you observe when you went back to the cafe with Mr. Depp?
When we went back to the cafe, he had a mark across the bridge of his nose. I got a bag of ice to put on it so that it wouldn't swell, just to make sure that it wasn't bleeding. And he walked over to the love seat at the cafe, and he laid down and went to sleep. And CJ came back over, and I asked CJ to stay there for the remainder of the evening, for the remainder of the morning. And I left CJ inside the cafe, and I left Johnny on the couch.
Ms. Heard, do you recall giving testimony in a deposition in this matter in January of this year?
I do.
You said he hit you and he was wearing rings, right, Ms. Heard? So he hit you with rings on every finger?
I don't know if I've ever known Johnny to not wear rings.
Yeah.
I'm not. I'm itching. I don't want to be doing this. Why don't you just say, okay, baby, I understand. I'll go home and you do your thing, hang out with your daughter, and then I'll see you in a couple hours and we'll talk about it. Is it that difficult to say that? Or you just fucking hate me and you want to be shitty about it? Please. Just fucking, it's not that difficult. Okay? I don't want to stand here in a driveway and argue with you. Okay, well, I'll see you in a little bit, okay? Please? Please. Just let me know if you're going to go somewhere. Just let me know, please, so I know. And let's not do this anymore, because I'm really getting frustrated. And I'm really, really...
Please.
really sick of this argument.
Stop, I'm sorry.
Okay, so let me go, and you go, and I'll speak to you in a couple hours. Okay? Okay?
Stop. Okay.
Why are you saying stop? May I go?
Please, it causes me so much stress when you leave, when you walk away from me with that. It's like you don't understand how much worse you're making this.
I can't believe this.
Please, you're making it worse for me.
Okay, I'm sorry for you.
Please, I'm only trying to tell you so that you know you're causing me immense stress right now when you walk away like that. There's no reason to be mad.
Then say goodbye. I haven't walked away. You're not saying goodbye. You won't let me fucking leave. Let me leave.
Stop rushing me! Stop pushing me in the corner and then poking me with a stick and then saying, why aren't you saying the words you want me to say?
But this is not love. This is not happiness. This is not.
Please stop doing this. Please, you're causing me so much fucking stress. I'm gonna die at this age. I'm gonna fucking die. You're causing me so much stress. Please stop. Please. I feel like I have a heart attack almost every day. Please stop. Please stop doing it. Please stop. He's so fucking mean.
Why are you fucking with me?
Bully. Stop. Please stop. I've been begging you not to fight. I just said, can we please have a normal argument? Just even a normal conversation. Fucking normal argument. And for the last hour, I've been begging you to please just leave it at that. Let's just go on with our night. I would have been able to come in with you. We would have been able to let it go in a few minutes. It would have been fine. It would just, if we allowed ourselves to have fucking normal arguments. Please, you're killing me with this. You're killing me. You're fucking killing me. Fuck.
Sean, could you, please, I want you to just go. I want you to take your medicine or whatever. I'm sorry that I've upset you.
Thank you, Sean. I'm ready to go. Thank you so much.
I'm really sorry.
I'm really ready. Thank
you. With histrionic, what you'll see is somebody who wants to be the center of attention, has sort of that impressionistic speech, very flowery, very enthusiastic, but nothing's really being said. The moment your attention wears away, because they're so demanding for attention, that's when they might take the victim role or the princess role and even make up stories. Sometimes those stories are to bolster the victim role. Sometimes those stories are just to make them look more interesting or accomplished in their mind so that they can get respect and attention that way.
I can't recall if it was bad news about my mother's health. I can't recall if it was something to do with my former business managers, finding out that they'd taken me for a very nasty ride. I don't recall exactly what it was about. What I do know is that it didn't have anything to do with her.
Jackson.
Happened this morning, you know that?
Were you in here?
No.
So then nothing happened to you this morning?
Yeah, you're right. I just woke up and you were so sweet and nice. We were not even fighting this morning. All I did was say sorry.
Did something happen to you this morning? I don't think so.
No, that's the thing.
You want to see crazy? I'll give you fucking crazy. Miss crazy. Oh, you're crazy. Oh, you're crazy.
Have you drunk this whole thing this morning?
Oh, you got this going. You got this going?
I just started it.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Really? Sneak that shit on me, motherfucker.
No, I didn't. You were smashing shit.
Bye. I'm not the one who fucking throws fucking pots and
that's different.
Fucking else at me.
That's different. Just because I've thrown pots and pans does not mean that you come and knock on the door. Just because there are vases does not mean that you come and knock on the door.
Really, I should just let you throw.
I'm not saying that. You're saying that. You're putting words in my mouth.
I was in an intense meeting that had a lot to do with not just my life and my future, but my children's. And I didn't know what was going to happen I didn't know what was going to happen. I didn't know if houses were going to start going away. I received a text from Ms. Heard asking me to bring, asked if I could bring some wine and some weed. And I texted back, sure. And then by the time I got to, arrived at penthouse 5, for the party, I was about an hour and 40 minutes late, maybe, something like that. Occasionally she would tear herself from the conversation that she was in
just to lean towards me. I was sitting to to her right, and I would get a quick earful of, I can't believe you've done this to me on my birthday. I can't believe, I'm so embarrassed, you know, which I found odd because I'd kept her informed all day.
You fucking haymakered me, man. You came around the bed to fucking start punching on me. Why? I love you. I've done nothing but lift your fucking heart. I've broken your fucking heart from the one person that I love and I trust.
You went to Coachella with your sister for her 30th birthday in 2016, right? Yes. And you testified that you were aware, I believe, that she and Mr. Depp had fought the night before?
Yes, I was aware that they had argued the night before.
You didn't see any bruises on Ms. Heard at Coachella that year, though, right?
Yeah, she was wearing a lot of makeup.
You didn't see any marks on her?
Not that I can recall.
Didn't notice any swelling, right?
To the best of my recollection, I don't.
Will she have advantage if she leaves him but files with police for abuse first? Was that a question that she asked you?
Yes, this was her talking out loud, trying to strategize for herself.
May I go?
Please, it causes me so much stress when you leave, when you walk away from me. I'm gonna die at this age. I'm gonna fucking die. You're causing me so much stress. Please stop. Please, you're killing me with this. You're killing me.